our force goals, our military policy, our deployments, and our war plans themselves must all reflect the purposes and spirit of our great community. Military and political problems are not separable, and military and political men must work ever more closely together. I hold an office which, by our very Constitution, unites political and military responsibility. And therefore, it is no more than my duty to pledge my own best effort to keep these two kinds of problem together in my mind. I ask the same of you. In ending, gentlemen, let me turn for one moment from our problems to our accomplishments. NATO has kept the peace of Europe and the Atlantic through 12 dangerous years. And in that time, our community has grown in strength and in well-being. This is no small accomplishment. I offer to you, and through you to all of NATO's armed forces, the thanks and congratulations of the people and the government of the United States of America. Let us continue from this bright past to a future which offers us the high task of guarding a free community's peace and its security and its freedom. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I'll just say one word, thank you.